Lately, we've been getting more warnings about HSBC Bank from billionaire hedge fund manager Kyle Bass and also top banking analyst for hedge funds and institutional investors, Christopher Whalen. So first, before I talk about those, let me talk about the HSBC Bank stock chart, as you can see here on your screen. Since the beginning of May 2019, the HSBC Bank stock chart has been in a correction. It was over $44 a share, almost $45 a share at the beginning of May 2019. And the stock started to slide about a month before the news of the Baoshan Bank bailout and Baoshan Bank or takeover, depending upon how you want to look at it. I'll just call it a bailout from the Chinese government, the People's Bank of China, and then all the other subsequent Chinese bank bailouts. And that's when the stock of HSBC Bank started its slide from $44.70 down below $40 in July and then into August. And really, since the beginning of August, as you can see there on the chart, the stock price of HSBC Bank has been in a fairly wide trading range between $35.53 and $39.52. And it's been stuck in a trading range for a while, although now it looks like it may be in a little bit of a downtrend. We'll have to see, because HSBC Bank has been, the management team has been trying to increase the dividend and, you know, do basic things that a company would do to try to move the stock price higher. But beneath the surface, there's a lot of red flags. Kyle Bass recently put out a tweet about a week ago talking about more senior executives and senior management at HSBC Bank, their China division and Asia division, which is their most profitable, leaving. So there's another couple senior executives, according to Kyle Bass, that are leaving. So that's another red flag. So yes, the stock price has not collapsed, but it looks like it could be sliding and it may eventually break that support level in the mid-$35 a share range. Finally, bank analyst Christopher Whalen, who is very well respected in the industry. He's not a retail bank analyst. He's a hedge fund and institutional bank analyst. He goes very, very in-depth on a lot of issues for his free blog website. There's a lot of very interesting things about the mortgage market, how he was talking about home equity loans are increasing again. He also writes in-depth research reports on a lot of these different banks, especially the banks he has listed in his bank Deadpool. They're available on his website, but there's a good amount of free resources there. And he was talking about HSBC Bank recently, I think on his January 13th blog post, and he's citing one of his bank analysts or money management friends that negative interest rates are not only the only source of risk to global banks, but Deutsche Bank might be in the crosshairs, but don't forget about HSBC. Hong Kong is looking like a black hole, and HSBC exposure to real estate on the island of Hong Kong. Let me add also that HSBC Bank probably has a lot of exposure to real estate in mainland China as well. So that makes the Deutsche Bank balance sheet look like Microsoft in the opinion of that analyst that Christopher Whalen is citing. So HSBC's U.S. operations are also in bad shape, years of credit losses and poor operational performance. If I remember correctly, a number of years ago, there was articles and research coming out that HSBC Bank was a very big lender into subprime auto loans. So HSBC Bank, there's a lot of red flags there. I don't know if I agree that HSBC is in worse shape than Deutsche Bank, but it's very interesting that there are very well-respected people out there in the financial industry that think that HSBC is in worse shape than Deutsche Bank. I find that very interesting. So if you want to read more of that article, it will be in the information and description section. But the bottom line is you have a billionaire hedge fund manager who is tracking the information in Hong Kong and China and looking at the stuff going on with HSBC Bank. Also the rumors, I've covered this, the rumors about HSBC Bank loaning hundreds of billions of dollars to Chinese banks and the People's Bank of China and Chinese government because they had a dollar shortage. And also those banks may have given them massive amounts of derivatives with forward dollar swaps that the Chinese banks and Chinese banking system are really struggling right now to pay back. So you have that, and then you have the one of the top banking analysts that is raising the red flags about HSBC Bank, along with Goldman Sachs, Citigroup, and everyone is well aware of the problems with Deutsche Bank. I even heard Deutsche Bank's derivatives book discussed on a CNBC Fast Money Trading. So that is very rare for people on CNBC Fast Money Trading to talk about Deutsche Bank's derivatives book. I was surprised to hear that. So let me know what you think. So yes, the shares of HSBC Bank have not collapsed yet, but there are a lot of red flags from people I respect that are saying that there's a lot worse potentially problems down the line to come. And it is worrisome about HSBC Bank's overexposure to real estate in Hong Kong, which has unbelievably high cost per square foot. And there's been a lot of laundered money that's been parked out of mainland China into Hong Kong in real estate. And then also HSBC Bank's exposure to real estate in mainland China, along with potentially a enormous dollar loan to Chinese banks, mainland Chinese banks, and the People's Bank of China. So we'll have to continue to monitor this.